Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. So yes, right now, we're actually in front of this tree on top of this hill right here because in the last part toward the ending, I actually said that we were going to go to Pooh's house next time. And that's actually incorrect. We did that like 20 parts ago. I guess I can see why. I forgot. But no, we're going to this bottom right portion of the map, or not the map, the book, to this area right here, which is a tree. A swing hangs from a stout tree. Take a look? Sure. I can go for a good swing. Look, Pooh, something is floating this way! I think you're right, Piglet. What could it be? Why, it looks like Eeyore! Hello, Eeyore, if it is you. He's just like floating along. Hello, Pooh. Yes, it is me. Could you pull me out? That is, if it's not too much trouble. Of course, you don't have to do it if you don't want to. Yeah, so we have Eeyore right here. He's like the clinically depressed one of the group. I don't know. Alright, so let's go check on Eeyore. I guess Pooh's not gonna jump in to save his best friend, Piglet for that matter. Come on, what kind of friend are you? Are you a freaking Winnie the Pooh or a Muppet or a man or a Muppet? I don't know. Thank you, Pooh. Thank you, other you. You know, floating along out there, it seemed like something was missing. And something's still missing. Why, Eeyore's tail is gone! Oh my god! Is that what's missing? Let's see, yep, lost it again. Wonder where it went this time. It's not much of a tail, though I'm sort of attached to it. Rimshot. But I don't know why anybody looked for it. Probably won't find it anyway. Sora, why don't we look for Eeyore's tail? Lost something? Oh god, no! No! No, god, no! No! Searching from a high place, the quickest way to find it. Owl, can you fly up high and help us find Eeyore's tail? Sorry, but my eyes aren't what they used to be. Too much reading, you know? But I can offer good advice. Please don't. Of course, you don't have to if you don't want to. See that swing up there? Take Pooh there. You're a bit too big for the swing, but Pooh should fit nicely. I'm too big? I'll tell you more when you get there. Alright, so we gotta get Pooh up to the swing somehow, but the trick of doing this is you just walk away and you expect him to follow you, but no. He actually only follows if you hold down R1 and lock on him. That's the only way he follows you, and look how slow he walks. Oh my, one of the slowest walk cycles in any video game. Are you kidding? Look at how he walks! He walks funny too, but... Oh man, while we're taking the trek to get up to the hill, I might as well get like a minute in right here to talk about- Wait, no! No! Pooh, you're getting distracted, damn it! No! Hey! Stop it! Stop! Alright, while he's eating- okay, he's not eating honey anymore. Yeah, he gets distracted by the honey, it's ADD in a food kind of sense. But anyway, I might as well talk about, something I haven't talked about really in my Kingdom Hearts videos is the fact that Kingdom Hearts 3D Dream Drop Distance is coming out soon. I saw the trailer of it like a couple weeks ago. I never actually talked about it. It looks freaking like kick-ass, man. I can't wait to actually have a purpose or a reason to get the 3DS. Like, I've been waiting to get it for that game, along with like Paper Mario Luigi's Mansion, but I don't know. When that game comes out, I'm definitely gonna buy one. That's why I had to get a battery for my PSP when Birth by Sleep came out, because it was dead all those years, and I actually had a reason to play it. So, yeah, it just goes to show, if you have good games on your library, people will buy your system. Here's what to do. First, get ready. Whoa, I went too fast. How? I actually need your explanation, Al. I went too fast over the scrolling text. Like this. Like this? Whoa, what are you doing to Pooh? Just slap his ass. Pedo human, I guess you would say. Then press R1 to give Pooh a push. Alright, press R1. Alright, how's this? Not bad. Here's the next step. Press R1 before he swings back to the bottom. If your time is right, Pooh will swing higher and higher. Try it! I'll help you with the time by spraying my wings and hit R1. But too soon, Pooh won't go any higher. Push too late, he'll go too high. Alright, so basically, just don't even look at Pooh, just look at Al. When he raises his wings, hit R1. Alright, so let's get him on his way. I don't know how this is going to solve finding Eeyore's tail, but, you know, pushing a guy in a swing might actually help. Help for a change, I don't know. Actually, come to think of it, this is doing nothing! Oh my god, Pooh! Holy crap! 23 yards! Wow, 23 is a spooky number, but oh god! Oh, there is his house, okay, I mean his tail. Ironically, on his house. We destroyed his house just to find his tail? That looks familiar. How's it looking? Sora's like sniffing his butt. What the hell? There we go. It's not much of a tail, but it's mine. Thanks, everyone. I wish we could put the 100-acre wood back the way it was, too. Aww. Now, we don't even, like, bring up the fact we destroyed his house. That's cruel. Look at this little back shot. Like, Owl's such an outcast. Like, why is he over there? Go with your friends, man. What's actually interesting is because I actually read that, I don't know if this is... Okay, hold on. The Torn Page turned into a new item. It was a Power of Time. Ooh, Stop to Stopra. Good magic spell, but I never used Stopra or Stop. But like I was saying, I actually read that, I don't know if it was the book or in the anime. I think it was the book. That Rabbit and Owl are actually the only living creatures in the 100-acre wood, because I think everyone else is based off of, like, a stuffed animal coming to life. And I actually read that Rabbit and Owl are actually the only two living creatures in the 100-acre woods, so that's pretty neat right there. And plus Christopher Robin, I don't think he's a stuffed animal, it's pretty creepy. But we have, like, this honey field over here, I guess we have time for that, so... A clearing crowded with stumps, take a look, sure. This must be Tigger's stomping grounds. I guess we gotta help him out and stomping or jumping around, having a good time. This here's my bouncing spot. We can bounce around here all day. Nothing beats bouncing. You wanna bounce too, Sora? It's lots of fun. Lots of fun, okay. Again with the maybe later, have some variety. To bounce with the finest, we'll need some pointers from the finest. Ow, how is he gonna teach me how to bounce? He's an owl. But Owl, you don't bounce around like we do. Get owned, Owl. I'm afraid you're right, I can't master everything, I suppose. I actually love how the game, like, makes fun of itself by having him always do the tutorials and now he's, like, leaving because he can't. That's funny. Bounce this way, please, or walk this way. Alright, so also we got a couple of platforming little mini-games to do right here because our bouncing is a form of a jump. Tigger bounce. Watch Tigger's bouncing pattern, then follow his lead. So it's kind of like Simon. Here's a little warm-up. That's not too hard. All we have to do is just follow his pattern and jump to him. Well, actually, I don't know if having my double jump is actually a good idea. I failed the first one? Oh my god, I actually practiced this one. This is like one of the ones I actually practiced because... The next one, the next to last one, is actually took me a while to do for some reason. Only like 5 tries. We'll be seeing later on why. It wasn't my fault. It was a certain aspect of this game that I brought up previously that I don't like. And okay, they get rid of the double jump. That's kind of weird. I remember having it in some of the other mini games, but whatever. And there we go. Fist pump. All right, give me another best shot. Now it gets tricky. Alright, a little tricky, but it looks the same nonetheless. It's kind of a little tricky dicky. Alright, so let's just see. This one? This one. This one? No, I failed! Fog nut! Alright, let's try this again. Okay, this one. This one. This one. What? I failed again? No! I'm really not paying attention. I guess my brain's fried from school day. I don't know. Booyah! Alright, give me another shot. You're doing fantastical! This will be the last one. Oh, here we go. This one's a doozy, folks. And yes, I don't get the physics behind them, how his Roo lift him up, but we're not gonna ask questions here. We're in the 100-acre wood. That jump is actually really difficult. We'll be showing off right here the reason why. This could be one of the more difficult aspects of this place. You go on top of the tree, but notice that the camera won't really look down, so you really don't know where you're even jumping. Like, look at this. How do I know where I'm jumping? It's kind of like a crapshoot. Sometimes, actually, like, if you go after a certain amount of time, it'll, like, go down to the ground, but still, like, how am I gonna look? Ah, crap. It's like crapshoot. Okay, let's jump. And I missed. I wonder why I missed. I don't know. Crappy camera, maybe? I have no idea. Alright, let's try this again. Hopefully the camera doesn't, like, not cooperate. Okay, we got some... Oh, whoa, there we go! Hey, it actually, like, focused in... Oh, no! It did... Okay, good. You have to, like, get to a certain area, then the camera actually cooperates. It's really weird. And not having a shadow doesn't help either. How am I supposed to, like... It's hard, for one thing, to know, like, where you're supposed to jump, but once you get the camera, you don't know where you're jumping to, because normally, in any video game, when you jump on an object, there's a shadow underneath the object, or on top of the object you're jumping to, that shows you where you're landing. Like, right there, it showed his shadow. He knew where he was gonna land. I'd fall down fast enough that it doesn't even show my shadow, so how is that fair? It's really hard, to say the least, and not really good game design. Let's see. Damn it, come on, I wanna get that camera. Alright, just fall down. There we go, okay. Maybe I can't react fast enough, I have no idea, but... It's definitely a hard puzzle, but there we go. We got it nonetheless. Alright, so what other tests we got here, Tigger? You got mighty good at bouncing, Sora! Right, Roo? What, you say right, Roo, and he hasn't even respond? Am I right? Did I do the right thing, Roo? Hey, Tigger, I think he's ready for the big one. The big one? Well, there's only one way to find out. Uh-oh. Tigger's giant pot. Whack the nuts back at the pot to shatter. Oh, that's mean. We're gonna shatter his pot. And you gotta be careful up here. If you fall off the stump, you automatically lose. So, doing jumping attacks while in midair and doing that forward A move. While effective, you could fall off potentially. So just watch out there. And you notice that locking on I was missing and now I'm doing it manually and I'm getting it? Yeah, you might want to take that strategy because locking on actually throws you off a lot. And probably be a reason why you fall off. I think it's much easier just to do it yourself. And there's no time limit, really. It's more of like a time, like, get the best time, you get the best score, or whatever. I don't know. And I don't get, like, one time the nut hits once, one time it hits four times. I really don't even know the scoring system in this game. Oh, what the hell? That was worth, like, what, seven right there? Jeez. Weird scoring system. That was worth two? Like, how do you grade that? Like, what the hell, man? I guess if it's higher in the air. Did I fall off? Oh, it's okay if I fall off. I didn't know that. I thought it wasn't okay. For some reason, I didn't think it was okay. Or maybe you hit the thing while you fall off. I have no idea. If you swing and miss and fall off, I guess it's a big deal, but... Or you start over. I don't know. I remember falling off. What the hell? Destroyed it? That was mean. Pooh would have definitely wanted that. You know how much honey could have fit in that thing? Jeez. Okay, where is he? Where's that crazy guy, Tigger? Where the hell is he? Seriously. We're fooling around, Tigger. Actually, is there something in here? Oh, there is, actually, once the pots got removed from it. An AP up, actually a very useful item. Let's just put that on right now. We'll go to stock. Not gummy. I went to everything but it before. And we'll use it on Sora because putting on another party member is useless. And is there anything here too? Man, there's a lot of items you can get. Can I get to that point? Okay, cool. That was cool, okay. Let's explore a little more around here. There's a lot of items I guess you can get. I didn't really notice that. It's cool. Okay, I can't break that. Can't break them all. Let's see here. An owl's just cowering in the corner like, oh man, I'm useless now. No one that respects me anymore. I wonder. Whatever. I'm sure I'll get a comment or saying something else is there. I don't know. Doesn't matter. Let's just get out of here or talk to Tigger. I don't know. Whatever comes first. Let's go try the seesaw. Okay, let's try the seesaw. I thought we were going to go up there, but what's Pooh saying here? This tree doesn't have any honey, I see. Okay. Good observation, Pooh. You should get a job doing that, inspecting trees, making sure they have honey. Alright, so, okay, the seesaw again. Who will you be your seesaw partner? I guess Tigger. Whoa, okay. I guess we can get into trees by doing this, but I don't know to what effect or to what reason. I guess we have to go over there. So let's see if we can just do this very intricately and very balanced. Don't want to fall off. Let's see, let's go over there. Ooh, I see a treasure chest over there. Definitely want to get over there. Let's just go very slowly. Slowly and jump over there. Camera wasn't that good, but if we go in here, we get a dispel G. Completely useless, but it looked cool, didn't it? Oh man, so let's just get through to catapult us and see how far we get. Okay, we go backwards. That's neat. Get some fruit up here. Pretty useless. Do I have a glide? Oh, I do. Okay, I didn't know if I had a glide still. Cool. I know if they took away my powers by going in here, but I guess we do have my powers. Or our powers. Let's see. Let's jump over here. The reason I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get to that treasure chest we saw. Okay. Whoa. I can definitely get up there by jumping on the stump. They wouldn't make me have to do that, would they? Would they? I can't even jump on the bushes. Damn, I want to get to that. I guess I'll cut till I get over there. Because I don't want to waste your time. Hey, look at over there. I found a little shortcut. I didn't have to go in the trees after all. And there we go. We got a mithril shard. So I think we're actually done in this area. I don't know. I talked to Tigger again. I talked to Roo. It doesn't really say if I was finished or not. But I guess I am. Oh, well, let's exit this place. Let's blow this popsicle stand. Later, dudes. Alright, a new torn page has turned into a nude item. A nude item? What? What was I saying there? Oh, whatever. But anyway, yes, I think we'll have to end it here. Thank you guys for watching. Next time, we will hopefully conclude Winnie the Pooh or the 100-Acre Wood and probably make some more progress and hopefully get out of this world once and for all. So I'll see you later, guys, and until next time.